management and diagnosis and treatment of DCI is a major complication of subarachnoid hemorrhage, and it's one of our main areas of research interest. And we study that both in experimental studies and in patients to try to find ways to prevent it from happening. Over the last 20 years, it's come down from about 60% of patients succumbing to the illness to about 35%. So despite surviving, we still have many people who are disabled after the hemorrhage. They're able to go home, for example, but they can't go back to work and look after their families in the way that they could beforehand. And this is especially a serious condition because the average age of a person with a subarachnoid hemorrhage is about 52 years old. So these are young people who are in the productive years of their lives, often with young families. We're able to study subarachnoid hemorrhage in animal models by recreating the condition, and that allows us to try to develop new drug treatments for preventing the complications of the hemorrhage in order to try to improve the outcome of these patients. Our hospital sees hundreds of patients with ruptured aneurysms every year, and we try to study as many of those patients as we can. We collect information in our studies on how they're doing afterwards, what their memory function is like, what their cognitive function is. We do sophisticated imaging studies with MRI, where we track which parts of their brain is working and which parts are not, and which parts have been injured. And then we try to correlate the differences that we see in those different patients and come up with ways to improve their outcome and improve the rehabilitation after the hemorrhage. At St. Michael's Hospital, we're privileged to be the lead site in the SAHET collaboration, which is an international group of investigators in subarachnoid hemorrhage. And we've collected the data on over 12,000 individual patients with subarachnoid hemorrhage. At St. Michael's Hospital, we treat hundreds of patients a year with subarachnoid hemorrhage. And this is a complex disease, and we have a team of physicians and nurses and other allied health professionals that collaborate and work together to try to give these patients the best chance of having the best outcome that they can after this devastating illness.